Tyler, I wanted to ask you about how athletics have influenced your college work experience and balance and balance studying and...
Well, I would say if you decide to play sports in college, it's going to have a huge impact. First off, they're going to be spending a lot of time with these people. You spend even more time than in high school. Because after practice, you'll go and you'll eat with them. And so you just have a whole lot more time with your teammates. So to me, it was important kind of to see the culture of the team that I was going to be spending the time with. It's a lot of work. That's one of the best decisions that I've made is to run track. I'm sure most athletes would say that they enjoy playing just because it brings you together, especially at the beginning. You have a set, an automatic group of friends that you'll be able to hang out with and kind of get accustomed to life. I would say sports was one of the high points in my freshman year. And I mean, it definitely makes you need to manage your time better, but there's definitely enough time to get your school done and also do well athletically.
One thing that for a lot of high school students is finances, that they are worried about how am I going to pay for college, how am I going to get through this without having $1,000 in loans and stuff like that. How do you guys manage that? And that can also be for you down there, how do you decide?
Each year.
applied to 15 schools because for actors, the acceptance rate at every school is about 2-3% on average. So to get the odds of getting these schools, I had to apply to many more. And for each one of those, I had to apply, write 2 or 3 essays, and then do an in-person audition. So to all my schools, whether that be in North Carolina, Michigan, New York City, I had to go to the school and actually show up for my audition. And they could ask me to do anywhere from 2 to 6 two-minute monologues to 10 songs completely through, and sometimes even dance, depending on what it was. So I was preparing this time last year, like May of last year, for my January through February.
I started like in junior year though, taking all the, I took SATs, ACTs, SAT subjects, that's all those. And then I applied to 5 schools, so I did 2 early, I think, and then 3 regular. So you can, if you have questions about any of the tests, you can ask me about those. I did the whole Common App thing, which is very convenient, except some schools don't take it. And I used essays over and over again. Like, I would copy and paste sentences out of different essays. Yeah. Like, I used them in English class, too. It was really nice, just because you wrote them also. It's just, it's like, reusing your own work. Really nice. I would definitely suggest doing that. If you have questions about all those applications.
Also, applications come out, like, August 1st. So if you're looking at a really long list of applications like I was done almost all my applications before school even started this year, so.
Did either of you, or did any of you actually look into scholarships at all? What kind of scholarships did you look at?
That's more, you do that in January of your senior year, starting then. So it's kind of after the application, or at least for me it was, so that was kind of nice. And they definitely pay off. If you apply to a bunch of them, even if you get one, it will pay off for all that. Because,
yeah. I don't have any scholarships because the only ones I would be able to get are through the school, and I would have to audition for them my freshman and sophomore. I don't have any going in, but.
Yeah, each school does it differently, so just research the schools that you're interested in so you know how they do their scholarships. I know for Eastern, you can get scholarships for music, you can get them for leadership, you can get them because of financial need, and I know the Honors College also gives really generous scholarships. And that's how these rumors, other schools, like another school I looked at was Grove City, and they don't give scholarships, but they start their tuition really low. So every school is going to be different. Just look into all the schools that you are interested in.
Also, if you have an obscure background or talent, there are scholarships out there for students who might be hard of hearing. If you are part American Indian, I think you have to prove that you're a quarter American Indian. There are tons of scholarships there for special things for students with learning disabilities. So if there's something special about you that would really earn you some money, don't depend on the schools to provide that. Really get out there on the internet and see if you can search for it. The other piece that we can't forget is the family income makes a lot of the difference on how much money the school will give you. So if your family income is not a lot, you may qualify for more aid. But always do the application because you never know through grants or scholarships what you'll get.
Okay, and to the students, how did having a Mennonite high school education influence where you looked for colleges?
Well, I knew I didn't want a school with any religious affiliation at all, so. That cut out a fair amount of the options. Doc talks about a lot, so.
Yeah, for me, I kind of, from the Mennonite, I think I really like Doc, the whole Mennonite thing here, but mm-hmm. I think after 4 years, I wanted to go out into, like, a non-Christian school
think for me coming through the, you know, PennU doc track, I didn't quite feel prepared for a like huge secular school, and that's just personal preference. But because I like the small like community, close-knit atmosphere of all of my education thus far, I wanted to keep going with that. But Eastern was enough diversity to branch out a little, but still have the feel of community.
And I kind of always liked the small school aspect. So, I mean, even though 900 people and the undergraduate class of EMU, I mean, it's a lot bigger, so it seems it was still a little bit of a culture shock, I guess, kind of coming from DOC. But at the same time, I feel like it's small enough that I can still, like, I know a fair amount, I'd say I know at least 70 to 80% of the freshman and sophomore classes, and then I know a fair amount of juniors and seniors too. So it's really cool just to be able to branch out and meet and really like actually get to know a lot of these people, which I think is really cool. I feel like I'm just kind of setting down roots a little bit, and it's just kind of fun to see what it's going to go into, what it's going to grow into. So yeah, I really like, and now this all small school is not for everyone, but if that's something you think you might like, you know, it's definitely a pretty good place for that.
Okay, well, we have to wrap things up here, but these guys will be available out in the comments.
Yeah, I'm going to jump in here. I'm going to give the panelists a minute to think about one last thing they want to share. So while they're thinking of that, what we're going to ask you guys to do is to let the panelists leave first so that they can go up and get their pizza and get settled. And then we invite all of you to join them. There's some tables set up along in the comments so you can buy pizza and soda and ask those personal follow-up questions. Maybe that's some of the things that you heard. If you guys want to just go down and give us a couple of pizza.
We didn't have like a hard copy.
We came up with a lot of them.
We just talked about it.